With Nvidia reaching a $1 trillion market cap, it almost seems like GPUs are the only hardware for the future of machine learning. But hidden from the spotlight, all big tech companies, including Google, Microsoft, Amazon, Meta, and Tesla, are working on specialized custom AI chips to power their own neural networks. Let's take a look at what big tech has been working on behind the scenes, because there will be a large gap between the winners and the losers of the AI hardware race. Custom AI chips are a new generation of hardware. When machine learning started to gain traction, researchers quickly realized graphics cards are much better suited for AI workloads than processors, because GPUs have a lot more cores than CPUs do, and AI calculations don't need the large instruction sets a CPU offers. That's where custom AI hardware comes in. They are silicon chips specifically designed to accelerate AI training and inference workloads. They pretty much only consist of lots of tiny cores and are limited to instruction sets relevant to machine learning. At the same time, a lot of research and design is needed to catch up with decades of GPU development. It's not easy to create new hardware from scratch. There are two reasons why every big tech company is currently developing their own custom AI chips. One is more performance and especially higher efficiency, as running large neural networks is very cost intensive. But the second reason is equally as important. No one wants to spend hundreds of millions of dollars on Nvidia hardware when you could spend the money on your own chips. The best example is Facebook, or rather Meta. Analyzing their quarterly earnings shows an obvious trend. Starting Q1 2022, we see a sharp rise in research and design spending, followed by a huge increase in capital expenditure from around $4.5 billion to almost $10 billion a quarter. If I had to guess, the increase in R&D is Meta ramping up their AI and machine learning efforts, and the increase in CapEx spending is them buying a lot of Nvidia GPUs. But we don't have to guess. Meta literally said so in their 2022 financial call, and I quote, "The current surge in CapEx is really due to the building out of AI infrastructure, which we really began last year and are continuing into this year." And since Meta is presenting new data centers on their company blogs, we can see what they bought. Thousands and thousands of Nvidia GPUs to power their AI data centers. Meta is actually one of the top three players in the AI market right now, only behind Google and Microsoft with OpenAI. But what is Meta using AI for? Are they planning a ChatGPT competitor? Meta is using AI for what they do best: trying to get as much advertising money out of Facebook and Instagram users. Meta's entire recommendation system is switching to custom AI, so-called deep learning recommendation models. Just 2 months ago, Mark Zuckerberg said the following: "Since we launched Reels, AI recommendations have driven more than a 24% increase in time spent on Instagram. Our AI work is also improving monetization. Reels monetization efficiency is up over 30% on Instagram and over 40% on Facebook quarter over quarter." Meta knows the huge impact a specifically trained neural network has for recommending the perfect content to its users, keeping them on the platform and thus making more money. If you caught yourself scrolling on Instagram or Facebook for longer than usual, AI is already affecting you personally. At the same time, Meta also knows how expensive Nvidia GPUs are. They literally spend hundreds of millions of dollars on them. That's where custom AI chips come into play. Just a few weeks ago, Meta unveiled their first custom AI chip called MTIA version 1. MTIA is short for Meta Training and Inference Accelerator, a pretty straightforward name. Meta's new chip is supposed to accelerate AI training and inference, although version 1 is more geared towards the inference part, which means running a machine learning model that has already been trained. MTIA V1 has a 373 squared millimeter large die and is produced by TSMC in a 7 nanometer process node. The chip runs at relatively low 800 MHz, but at the same time only has a 25 watt TDP. Performance-wise, MTIA V1 achieves a little over 100 TOPS INT8 and over 50 teraflops FP16. Not a lot compared to T2000 INT8 and 1000 FP32 a Nvidia H100 GPU can churn out, but at the same time, it also uses less power, which gives it the efficiency edge. And I'm sure it's also cheaper to produce for Meta, being half the die size on a much cheaper process node and with no Nvidia margins to pay for. Interestingly, this chip is kinda old news. Meta started producing MTIA V1 back in 2021, and they have been buying a lot of Nvidia hardware in the meantime, which means they either can't produce enough of them, or maybe there are other kinds of hardware or software problems that force Meta to continue buying Nvidia GPUs while having their own custom AI chip. But this is only the beginning. The chip is called V1 for a reason, and even if version 1 has its shortcomings, version 2 will be better. It might take Meta more revisions, but you can be sure, it's only a matter of time before Meta's AI recommendation networks will fully run on their own custom AI hardware, ending the reliance on Nvidia GPUs. Google, on the other hand, has a lot of experience with custom AI chips. Their so-called Tensor Processing Units, or TPUs for short, are already on version 4. Back in 2015, long before the Transformer model, Google released their first TPU. It was a single chip with 8GB of slow DDR3 memory, only capable of inference. In 2017, the much larger TPU V2 was released. Now on a much improved 16nm node, it had 3 times the amount of transistors, a larger 16GB HBM memory, and supported both AI inference and training. The new B-Float 16 format was especially impactful and has since become one of the most commonly used formats in machine learning, as it combines large numbers with high throughput and can be easily converted from FP32. TPU V2 also included network links, allowing Google to combine up to 256 chips into a single AI supercluster called TPU pods. In 2018, Google released TPU V3, basically a V2 on steroids. The chip grew to almost 700 square millimeters on the same 16nm process node, was clocked much higher and used twice as much memory. The TDP exploded to 450 watts, which was offset by water cooling, and improved networking increased the TPU pod size to 1024 chips, allowing the creation of AI supercomputers. For its fourth generation, Google's not only switched to a 7nm process node, but also increased their lineup with a classic TPU V4 for training and inference, but also a TPU V4i specifically designed for inference only. This version is using its own chip. At almost half the die size, it's cheaper to produce, while delivering similar efficiency. This move was to be expected because, while training large language models takes a lot of computing power, the much more difficult part Google and all other big tech companies are facing is how to run inference for billions of customers. If AI will become a part of search in the future, inference cost has to decrease by orders of magnitude, only possible with customized AI silicon. But Google isn't only using their AI chips internally. You can rent them as part of Google's cloud offerings. If you need to train a large language model or run inference for your already trained neural network, Google Cloud has you covered, and you can rent everything from individual cards to whole TPU superpods. And while Google also offers Nvidia-based systems, I think the direction is clear. Google is closing in on a decade of experience designing and using custom AI hardware. They certainly don't envision a future based on Nvidia GPUs. Before we talk about Microsoft's AI hardware ambitions, let's take a look at another player that has been under the radar when it comes to custom AI hardware, Amazon. In 2015, Amazon acquired Israel-based Annapurna Labs, a company specialized in AI hardware. Since then, AWS started to offer custom AI chip instances as part of the AWS cloud services, one for inference called Inferentia and one for training called Trainium, with up to 190 teraflops of FP16 performance and 32GB of HBM memory. Amazon isn't seen as a big player when it comes to AI, but with AWS, they offer a lot of AI compute performance, and part of it is based on Amazon's own custom AI hardware. With the increasing interest in AI workloads, I'm sure Amazon will focus on also increasing their custom AI offerings, not only for AWS clients, but also within the company. And with the deep pockets of Amazon, you should expect more to come. Microsoft is an interesting topic, because on one side, they are the main AI player due to the close cooperation with OpenAI. Microsoft operates huge AI clusters with tens of thousands of Nvidia GPUs. But on the other side, Microsoft is late when it comes to custom silicon. But this is about to change. Codenamed Project Athena, Microsoft is developing its own custom AI chip. We don't have much information at the moment. Supposedly, the design process started in 2019 and the chip has been taped out with first samples available for testing. If all goes well, mass production could start later this year. Now, it's unlikely that Microsoft's first-gen hardware will be immediately able to compete with solutions from Nvidia, AMD, or even Google. But again, the direction is clear. The number one priority is to decrease the cost of inference that ChatGPT and the integration of similar models into Bing Search and Windows and Office products create. I wouldn't be surprised if Athena is targeting inference first. Even if it takes another 2 generations, Microsoft's vision of its AI future is certainly not based on Nvidia GPUs, both for internal use and their Azure customers. Once we know more about Athena, you can expect a video on the hardware details. Last but certainly not least, let's talk about Tesla. Tesla is using neural networks to train their self-driving software, which means they need huge amounts of training power to create a neural network, and then they need efficient inference so that every Tesla car can actually use the AI model while driving. In August of 2021, almost 2 years ago, Tesla announced their custom Dojo D1 chip, although they are only going online this year. The Dojo D1 is produced in TSMC's 7nm node and has a die size of 645 square millimeters. With 354 cores at 2 GHz clock speed, it achieves over 360 FP16 or BFloat 16 teraflops at around 400 watts CDP. But that's not all. Dojo is designed with scalability in mind, connecting them to so-called training tiles with 25 chips each, and then combining 120 of these tiles into a single AI supercomputer with over 1.1 exaflops of BFloat 16 performance. There's so much to say about Dojo, it could fill an entire video of its own, but it reaffirms the same story we have talked about this entire video. Custom AI hardware isn't only the future, it's already here. With the huge AI compute needs Tesla has, custom AI hardware is the only feasible solution. And you can be sure that the next generation of Tesla chips are already being worked on. Circling back to the start of this video, it's interesting that Nvidia is the only truly visible AI hardware company when so much is going on behind the scenes. Literally every big tech company already has custom AI hardware or is working hard to get there. And while the first generation hardware might not be able to compete Nvidia in terms of performance, efficiency or scalability, I'm pretty confident that in 5 years' time, all big players will rely on their custom AI chips. But not only big tech is changing. If you can't afford to design your own custom AI chip, companies like Tenstorrent are hard at work to outcompete Nvidia with chips only made for machine learning. At the same time, a lot of compute is starting to move from the cloud to the edge. This Coral AI Edge TPU is based on Google technology and provides about 4 TOPS of INT8 at only 2 watts. Your mobile phone most likely has an integrated AI chip, like Apple's Neural Processing Unit. At this week's WWDC, Apple announced that AutoCorrect is moving to a machine learning model, directly running on the NPU inside your iPhone. AMD's latest Ryzen 7000 Phoenix mobile CPUs and Intel's next-gen Meteor Lake also include custom AI hardware. The revolution has already started. Now the only question is, who will come out on top? You know what to do if you enjoyed this video, and see you in the next one.